So, what we are going to study, we are going to study the characteristic of your separately excited DC machines. You are now well aware of the characteristic of your DC shunt motor and DC series motor. And now you will come to know that in spite of the fact that DC shunt and series motor machines are not in our syllabus, I will taught you that. Okay. So, the reason was, both in shunt wound DC motor and separately excited DC motor, field is supplied from constant voltage. Okay, so that the field current is constant. Now you can see, this is the diagram of your shunt wound, and you can see that this is the voltage which is, you know, same although, but when we have drawn the characteristic of operating characteristic of your shunt field, we have drawn the characteristic speed और आर्मेचर करंट की. द फर्स्ट थिंग विच आई हैव टोल्ड यू इज कि हम वी हैव टेकन द वोल्टेज कॉन्स्टेंट. दैट्स वाई द फील्ड करंट एंड इवेंचुअली द फ्लक्स वॉज कॉन्स्टेंट. ओके, वी हैव टेकन दिस कॉन्स्टेंट. सिमिलरली इफ यू कैन सी हेयर, यू हैव कॉन्स्टेंट एक्साइटेशन हेयर. ओके, यू आर एक्साइटिंग योर वोल्ट, यू आर एक्साइटिंग योर वाइंडिंग्स, योर फील्ड थ्रू द कॉन्स्टेंट through the constant voltage. That's why these two motors have similar speed armature current and torque armature current characteristics. Okay, so what you came to know, that these two motors, your shunt motor and your separately excited DC machines, have same characteristic. The first one is your speed armature characteristic, speed armature current characteristic. This I representing armature current here, and your the second one is your torque armature current characteristics. The first one is, as we know, the speed of the DC motor is proportional to the back EMF, or you can say flux. When the load is increased, the back EMF and flux, when load is increased, back EMF and flux decreases due to armature resistance drop and armature reaction separately. However, back EMF decreased more than flux, so that the speed of the motor slightly decreased with the load. This is the speed, this is for your speed and armature characteristics. Secondly, your torque armature current characteristic. Here, torque is proportional to the flux and armature current. Neglecting armature reaction, your flux is constant and torque is proportional to the armature current. Your torque current characteristic is straight line passing through the origin. From the curve, we can see that the huge current is needed to start heavy loads, so the type of motor do not start on heavy loads. Okay, so you can see here, for your torque current characteristic and your speed armature current characteristic. These are your characteristics. This is for shunt DC motor, and this will remain same फॉर द सेपरेटली एक्साइटेड मोटर. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे जो शंट की दे रखी है, फॉर योर सिलेबस यू विल सी, आपके सिलेबस में दे रखा है कि आपको क्या करना है, ऑपरेटिंग कैरेक्टरिस्टिक देखनी है. किसकी देखनी है? सेपरेटली एक्साइटेड मशीन की. सेपरेटली एक्साइटेड मशीन की जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स होती हैं वो सेम होती हैं आपके डी सी शंट मोटर की कैरेक्टरिस्टिक की. एंड द रीज़न इज दे इन बोथ द मशीन्स द फील्ड इज सप्लाइड फ्रॉम द कॉन्स्टेंट वोल्टेज. That's why we get the same characteristics for them. ठीक है, that is the reason. ठीक है, एक बार आप इसे देख लीजिए, characteristic देखिए. और कल मैंने आप लोगों को कल DC shunt की दिखाई थी मैंने characteristic. और to be more precise, we can see it from here, from this particular book. One second. So where it is, armature block. So we have this DC motor, DC motor. Okay. Shunt, you know? This is shunt and this is series. Again, we have this compound. Torque characteristic of DC motor, shunt. So you can see that the speed characteristic of DC motors are is governed characteristics of DC motor if we talk about speed, then it is governed by this particular equation, and you have to see this particular equation if you want to see the speed characteristics of DC motor. In case of shunt, you can see the field winding of a shunt motor consists of many turns. Okay, the flux therefore remain constant. Since the drop IARA at full load rarely exceed 5% of V, the speed N is almost constant. ठीक है, आपने जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक देखा था, वन सेकेंड, यहाँ पे भी दिया होगा, और इफ इट इज नॉट गिवन वी विल सी. ठीक है, ए देखिए, दिस इज योर ए, दिस इज शोइंग योर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, दिस ए इज शोइंग द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ स्पीड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ योर यू नो शंट मोटर. आप इसको देख लीजिए, शंट मशीन या मोटर. ओके, आप इसे देख लीजिए, खाली इसे देखिए. इनिशियली इट इज कॉन्स्टेंट, इट इज फॉलिंग डाउन समवॉट. ना इसका रीजन क्या है, इसका रीजन है यहाँ पे देखिए, इट इज ऑलमोस्ट कॉन्स्टेंट. Its speed characteristic may be represented by curve A. Thus, the DC shunt motor is constant speed motor. The drop in speed with current is even less than the shown in the figure. This is because the armature current increases. The armature reactions tend to slightly reduce the main flux. The reduction in flux causes an increase in speed that partially compensates the drop due to IARA. Okay, it is almost constant, but some drop is there, and due to that drop, the speed is slightly decreasing, but it is not decreasing that much. You can consider it constant, but why this certain, or you can say the minute drop is there, it is due to the armature reaction that is tends to slightly reduce the main flux, and due to this, that reduction of the main flux, the speed is reducing somewhat. Okay, that was the first characteristic, that was the speed characteristic. And what is the second characteristic, your torque characteristic. Okay, so if we talk about shunt motor, the torque characteristic is governed by this particular equation, that is your torque is equal to KIA phi, and if you consider the flux constant as you are supplying it the field winding with constant supply, then your torque is, you know, flux is directly proportional to IA, then your torque is directly proportional to IA square. So IA. Then since the flux of shunt motor is practically independent of armature current, your torque is directly proportional to IA, hence the torque characteristic is represented by a straight line, that is A. So, हमने कल भी पढ़ा था शंट के केस में क्या था, directly proportional था, and the relationship was linear. So you can say see if it is if they have drawn it somewhere, it is not here, but you can draw the linear. Okay, it is here, you can say A is here, na? A is, you know, linear. A is showing the linear relationship between torque and the current. Okay, so you have, what you have to see according to your syllabus, you need to see the characteristic of your separately excited DC machine, and it has the same characteristic that of the shunt DC machine. And what is the reason of that? Because both are supplied with the constant, you know, voltage. In both the cases, the winding is supplied through the constant voltage. और ये आपका जो ए है, दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, दिस ए इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग द स्पीड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक. सो यू कैन सी हेयर द स्पीड इज करंट, इवेंचुअली इट इज लाइक कॉन्स्टेंट. द समवॉट ड्रॉप इज ड्यू टू द आर्मेचर रिएक्शन, एंड ड्यू टू विच द फ्लक्स इज रिड्यूसिंग समवॉट, बट इट इज क्लोज टू, यू नो, कॉन्स्टेंट. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ मोटर इज यूज फॉर, यू कैन से द कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड एप्लीकेशन. यू कैन यूज दिस मोटर टू द for the constant speed applications, and where you need the constant speed, and at the same time the torque, you can see that torque is increasing linearly. Okay, with this relation one can see as the your flux is, you know, almost constant, that's why, and K is already a constant, your torque is directly proportional to IA, that's why the relationship here is linear. And you can say that, okay, my the torque relationship, the torque and current relationship in case of your DC shunt motor is, as well as your separately excited DC machine, is linear. So that was about the characteristic of your DC separately excited DC machine.